This is Go Live TV Hour, my man, Chiquetto, in the building. We ain't actually talking on air yet, but we will in a minute. So, you know, I want to get an intro and a shout out for coming all the way up here from North Carolina to see us. You know what I mean? How we know it, know it, know it. We're about to get into it. So here we go. Go Live TV. Go Live TV Hour, power, live podcast from Grind City. Sunday nights, 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on JPBTV.com, UniqueBlendTV.com, or Ustream/channel Go Live TV Hour from your mobile, live in the mix. DJ Who the F Ever, spinning all indie hip-hop and R&B videos. One feature, call 412-475-8313 and watch Sunday nights, 8 to 9 p.m. Go Live TV Hour, power. Go Live TV Hour. We are live. JPBTV.com and Ustream.com. My man Chiquetto is in the building. What up, Roham?
What up, Buttons?
Say what's up to the world.
What's up, world? Chiquetto.
Chiquetto, man. Good oh, man. You know what? I'm so excited that you are here. Like a lot of people. I got to find us a beat, Chiquetto. We need the music to make the music.
Gotta drop a dope beat.
We got to drop a dope beat. Oh, no. I got to find it. But why I find a beat? First of all, real quick, tell everybody kind of what it is that you do, and then we're going to get into specifics about it.
All right, well, kind of what it is.
Kind of what it is, what you do.
I kind of build and manipulate puppets. That's what I do. I use all recycled materials, built over probably like over 65 puppets in 10 years. So I'm, you know, getting good at it, getting a lot of work. Started out street performing in Carrboro, North Carolina. Then I got pulled in to do, you know, shows with certain puppet theaters, and here I am.
In the Berg. Now, back in the Berg. Now, because you are from Pittsburgh, PA.
Definitely.
Actually, Clareton, right?
Clareton, PA.
And then, as you got a little older in your youth, you switched up and you came to the east side of it. What was it like to go from Clareton, which seems kind of like a distant land to the people in the city of Pittsburgh, to come inside the city and be on the east side? Was that like a huge transition?
I was a country bumpkin, you know, since a small town. You know, so a lot of most people are related. So I moved to Wilkinsburg. Yeah. Was the first, you know, place I moved to. Culture shock, you know what I'm saying? It was like the young cats was like jumping people for fun.
Yeah,
you know,
right?
What I'm saying? Like,
wait
what
a
is
minute.
This? What are y'all doing? You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, this is how we get down here from here.
Wow.
So I learned, you know, I learned all the territories and boundaries. And then from there, I moved to East Hills, which is much more so territory. You know, if you went from up there, you went loud up there. You know, but, you know, then went to Taylor Alderdice.
And Taylor, Taylor Alderdice, you know, a lot of y'all, those stars come up out of there. We
I'm starting to see a trend.
Yeah, we had a mayor come out of there. But that's kind of like a melting pot.
Yeah.
To come from like East Hills and then go to Taylor Alderdice, where you got Squirrel Hill, which is kind of like the rich cats. And
exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what was that like?
Like, it was a melting pot. It was like a baby America. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you had
right.
The East Hills cats. You had Homewood coming from Kappa, was doing the magnet thing.
Mm-hmm,
you know what I'm saying? I was in a creative, it was like a creative arts class, like the first three periods. And matter of fact, my man Jerome Scott, Disaster Tempo, was in that class.
Oh,
with me.
Shout out Jerome.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
What's
and my man Squeeze, that's where I met him. And we started doing hip hop and drawing and graffiti.
What you know about hip hop?
I know a lot about hip hop.
Hell no, no, hip hop. We're gonna test
elements.
You later.
I did all five.
You did all five. Tell them what the five of Dave. For those who don't know, these are the five elements of hip hop. 1, 2, 3, go.
Rap, DJing, b-boying. I'm stuck. It's like I'm nervous. Fashion. You know what I'm saying? And I'm missing the fifth. Help me out.
Would you say rap?
Yep.
DJing.
Yep.
Fashion. B-boy.
B-boying.
Rap. Oh wait.
There's
wait,
one
wait,
more.
Wait, 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 wait. Beatboxing, ain't it? Arguably it was arguably it'd be beatboxing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I should be ashamed and embarrassed, but I don't care.
We don't care.
You know what I'm saying?
We hip hop is. Say what you want. We ain't Grind City.
Later.
You don't got to get grassy. Welcome to Grind City, man. It's nice to see you here. Now, as you got, you know, into this, you start becoming an MC, you were a painter, you were doing all these things, and you start hooking up with cats like the British Butters.
Yeah.
And people in Pittsburgh don't know how strong the British Butters was serious.
It was like a guild. You know what I'm saying? Now, even like the grant writers and everything were coming to us like, we're doing a show. Do y'all know anybody?
Wow.
And Kamalo ended up just like
Kamalo
running it.
Man, peace out to Kamalo.
Kamalo
man.
Where?
Yes.
Running
he's doing Tabs or something now. What is he doing?
Man, he has a studio in Brooklyn.
Yeah,
production of film.
You know, wow. I want to be down. I like him. I mean, like, what, you know, in Pittsburgh at the time, when you were doing the Bread Spotters, I was kind of figuring out what hip-hop was in Pittsburgh. And we didn't... If you weren't in the Bread Spotters and kind of like with 18 Class of 24, you weren't doing hip-hop in Pittsburgh. What makes you see the culture here now, even though you're not here. What do you think changed the B-boy backpacking culture of hip-hop in Pittsburgh compared to what we had, to what we have now?
There was a lot more unity back in the day. There was a lot of support.
Ooh.
I've seen that, mm-hmm. like even towards the end, there is, you know, just people just had different visions, and their vision came first instead of putting visions together. People started going their own way. I mean, I don't know how it is now, having like been on the scene.
We're gonna talk about where you been, bro. You been traveling, bro.
Yeah, through social media, I see what's going on here. I have to follow you to know what's going on.
Poor thing, you don't know nothing. Don't know much. You don't follow me to know what's going on in Pittsburgh. I have been kicked out of the loop. I stay in this little thing. And that's all right. I deal with it. But I only mentioned that because you've been able to take all of these different skills that you've gathered with your emceeing, your painting, your poetry, and just it's like your puppets are a collective effort from all of those skills. And sometimes you have to revisit the hip-hop and the painting to really understand who this little guy is. Who is that?
This is just called Spider. You know, so I keep the
I'm scared of spiders. Is it going to bite me? Bite me, Spider!
He might bite me.
He's gonna let Spider. Hi, Spider.
I mean, I took this as a challenge because how am I gonna make 8 legs? You know what I mean? Move individually.
Right.
So my puppets are like hybrids. You know what I'm saying? You have the few families of puppets. You have marionettes, which is, you know, hang by strings. There's rod puppets. Like, you know, there's Muppets where, you know, there's hordes. And I merge them. This is like a rod puppet / marionette.
And is that a patented style that you come up with that, or you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like, is that
it's
authentic?
Unique. It's completely authentic.
Wow.
I haven't seen anybody do it. I just hit your microphone.
That's all right, Mike, check 1, 2, 1, 2, that's hip hop.
As a matter of fact, that's a good question, because I worked with this one puppet theater, Paper Hand. And there's two directors, you know, they co-founders. And we were putting a show together, so, you know, I came with my style of puppets, and he was like, you know, your puppets, you know, whatever kind of puppets those are, you know, we'll use those. And I, like, kind of took offense, because I'm, you know,
what
do you mean?
Whatever kind of
puppet
you mean? We from the
hood.
He was
like, no. He was like, I've been all over the world. I've never seen what you did with the puppet, how you put it together, how you control it. That's what I meant. I was like, you know, cool.
Did you name it? Like, after that, did you say, okay, this is what type of puppet it is?
Nah, because, no? I mean, I will break them apart and rebuild them. This wasn't like that a couple years ago. It was it was just a marionette. And I just figure out different ways to make it move, and I go in and...
Now, will you keep this? You won't break this down? Will you keep this?
I don't know. If I could find a better way to manipulate it, I'll take it apart and rebuild it.
Wow.
Or build another one. This is like a prototype for a different...
Right. Now, do you... You know, we're going to get deeper into this, but do you build... Like, if someone says... Can you build me a puppet? Do you build them and sell them?
Or do commissions.
You
do? Yeah.
There's a hustle in everything. Oh, yeah. This is the point of the question. There is a hustle in everything. This bro will build you a puppet that look like you. Quit playing.
Yeah.
Hey, we're gonna get into a couple videos, because this is what we do on the Go Live TV Hour. We play independent music videos, and we talk to people like him who are independent thinkers, creators, you know what I'm saying? So we're gonna get into some of this music, and when we come back, we're gonna talk more about what he's been up to and the Missy Elliott video, because I know y'all want to know how he got that Nevy Musk scrunchies. I know you want to know. Y'all just want to know. You got to know. They got to know everything, Terrence. You know what I'm saying? You can't hide nothing from. We'll be right back. Go Live TV Hour. It's our power. It is kind of what we do here. It's her.
Yo. I don't really do the talking shit good. But I talk shit good. Y'all know what I mean, man. D-Town, the north side of Welcome to the EP, 330, let's go. Northside guy, chick, I'm nice, fuck your motto. In the streets deep, you'd have thought it was a pothole. Sucker MCs hate me and my bravado, but y'all cats is dinner like I'm dining at your mottos. Swear up and down on the gram, she a model. Got a 250,000 likes and a 250,000 follows. Thinking she the baddest bitch and everybody want those. Till you fuck around and catch her working at McDonald's. She was hiding from herself, afraid she wouldn't excel. And fucked around and became someone else as well. Then I expressed my thoughts, said, look at yourself. Everybody trying to be anyone else but themselves. And you trying to be somebody when everyone's taken. Just be yourself, girl, that is still vacant. But my words couldn't get nearer, cause she didn't recognize the woman in the mirror. Chick got mad, decided to cop an attitude. It's whatever, chick, I ain't got time to be mad at you. I'ma hit 5th and just cruise the avenue, trying to reach a brand new launch in latitude. When I show up, show a little gratitude. I'm fly as fuck in a brand new altitude. Given that I doubt you choose, one thing's for certain, I'm not about to lose. I taught them everything that they know, that they know, they know. Taught them everything that they know, they know. Taught them everything that they know, that they know, they know. Didn't teach them everything that I know. So tell me, when we lose the way, went from MLK to Juicy J. And I don't mean no disrespect to the man, but if bands will make a dance, tell me what's the chance that that same woman will rise and take a stance against cops who kill boys with no weapons in hands, against these criminals killing kids over Skittles, against these hate crimes lighting candles at the vigils. It's paradoxical, these fucking obstacles can't do nothing else to slow me down or stop me, bro. I'ma do each and everything possible to make sure that the radio don't block the flows. The American dream seems more like the American scheme. At times, I question the process. Not tripping, I just question the progress. Back to the real shit, get the fuck up out your feelings. This is that everyday bullshit that people deal with. Never thought that half of y'all would feel it. When they tell you sky's the limit, then you fucking hit the ceiling. Back to the real shit, get the fuck up out your feelings. This is that everyday bullshit that people deal with. Never expected half of y'all to feel it. When they tell you sky's the limit, then they stop you at the ceiling. You tell them everything that they know. That they know, they know. Taught them everything that they know. They know. Taught them everything that they know. That they know, they know. Didn't teach them everything that I know.
You ever been laying in your room, just staring at the ceiling, reflecting on life? Well, that's kind of what I'm doing right now. Y'all mind if I talk a little bit? Listen.
I was laying at the bottom, staring at the top. Yep. I had to take a piss, but I ain't have a pot. Nah. I came from a place where we ain't have a lot. Nah. A roof and four walls, man, I swear I love that box. That's look, it. My environment was crime heavy. Only thing consistent was getting locked and doing time steady. Shit. I used to look out my window and see the D-boys. But you. That block life, it was supposed to be a detour. Damn. I seen hustlers get trapped in the trap, because they failed to realize that the trap is the trap. Listen, I ain't knocking because I tried pitching. Uncle supplied me the pack and spatula and watch me try flipping. Growing up, it was hard living. Imagine learning to be a man when you was raised by all women. But it's cool though, cause see I made it out, surrounded by hustlers and killers, and I ain't have to take that route. My environment molded me. Looking at other dudes, I realized that ain't what I'm supposed to be. See, I'm destined for greatness and I can feel it now. My people's fighting some cases that he appealing now. And easily I could have been on the other side, but it hurts to see the pain in my mother's eyes. Growing up, I always had a sense of pride. My father's eyes, but I'm built with my mother's grind. See, I remember stretching dollars, making ends meet. People talking about money, I'm sitting there scared to speak. Living check to check, every dollar spoken for. Walls closing in, and I can't find an open door. So I'm patiently waiting for my day to come. There's no way out, I guess I gotta make me one. The small shit, I just paid no mind. See, I'm focused on the prize, so I stay on my grind. Look, my daughter need this, and my son need that, and they ain't asking you for shit when they could call on dad. A good night's sleep I ain't have in a long time. Tossing and turning, I got a ton of shit up on my mind. Wow, I did a lot of shit just to live this here lifestyle.
What else?
I came straight from the bottom to the top. My life, wow.
Like back in on, you know, I gotta hit the button. Let's get it. Go Live TV Hour. We are back. We had to bring that Master Ace because we was in here talking about Master Ace. It was his fault. You don't play no Can I Get a 16? He had to bring it up. So, you know, we had to drop that Master Ace, Can I Get a 16? Because we were talking about how MCs were coming back from, you know, in our era when we grew up and playing the game because the game is kind of all messed up. So we had to, you know, bring that back. Anywho, speaking of which, you don't live in Pittsburgh anymore. You're in North Carolina. And, you know, you migrated, my man, Rampage migrated, T-Reed migrated. There's a lot of us that were like the hip hop boom coons, the artists here, the painters here, leaving.
Yeah, all around the same time.
All around the same time.
05, 04.
And making it. What do you think the difference is between the atmospheres? What makes it possible for you to say, you know what, I came up here, I did all this, and I'll go down there, I start something completely different and succeed?
I mean, I just had to reinvent myself. You know, so up here, I was a painter, you know, poet, barber. Mm-hmm. And I moved down there. I was like, I can be anybody I want to be down here. And I built my first puppets here. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I was actually doing I was hosting a poetry night at the Bridge Spartan spot downtown with a puppet.
Right.
His name was Dobie Livewire.
Dobie
Livewire. Because he was made out of wire. That's how I started making puppets.
That's hard, dude. That's hard.
This is how I started making puppets. Should I just go into that?
I mean, you can. I was going to ask you, but go ahead. How'd you start making puppets, bro?
All right. I was doing these wire sculptures. I would take wire and I would just keep wrapping it until it turned into a form and it looked like scribble. Mm. So I called it 3D scribble.
That started
because my oldest daughter, she's 18 now. Hey, Cece.
Cece.
She locked herself in the bathroom, and I opened up a wire hanger when wire hangers were has to.
No more wire hangers!
Oh. You know, I had to open it and, like, you know, pop it up, open the door. So I looked at the hanger and was like, oh. Hmm. And I twisted it into a face.
Wow.
You know what I mean? I started doing, like, these crazy abstract sculptures, and then I seen the sculpture I was making. I was like, make one move. So I just made a real crude, like, abstract wire puppet, and I just put clothes on it.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Wired it up. So, I, you know, as a matter of fact, I put my 13-year-old, he's 13 now, I used to take my son's clothes when he grew out of them. You know, my son had a pair of shell toes. I said, can't wait till he outgrow those.
Wow. You plotting on the shell toes to put them on the puppets.
Yeah, and the flannel with some jeans. Rocked it.
When did you grasp that your mind just worked differently? That you can make something come alive out of a piece of wood or a wire hanger? Like,
that's always been.
Really?
That's always been.
You just run around mama's house twisting up stuff.
Yeah, I mean, when I was a little kid, we used, you know, the ice cream truck would come around. Right. You know, we in the project, so, you know, we couldn't afford, you know, like, really nice toys. I mean, every once in a while, a friend would get something, but we just used what we had, man. We used to play cowboys and Indians. We used to take the, more like Indians and Indians.
Indians and Indians.
You know what I'm saying? You know, we didn't want to be the authority.
Right.
But,
right.
We used to take the popsicle sticks, and we used to, like, rub them on a curb corner and make designs out of them, sharpen the front of it, and stick it into a straw, a drinking straw, and use a rubber band and, like, shoot them at each other. Wow. We was, like, doing stuff like that as
kids.
No,
you're a father. Are your children like that? Are they creative like that?
Definitely.
Like, do they like the puppets? Like,
my 7-year-old is actually just as or more into it as I am. My son, Taryn.
The one that's seen with the violin puppet?
Yeah.
Yes.
No, like, in that picture, I didn't set that up. I was doing my thing. I looked down, and he, like, took it on himself to get the chair and the little puppet and started doing it on his own.
Wow.
I looked down and was, like, shocked. And
wow.
Yeah, it's a beautiful
thing. Did you ever, like, make a puppet that's kind of catered after one of your children? Like, the actions of it, the behavior of it, that, you know, like, all right, you're bad. Like, we got Amy over there. I know you brought Amy Rhymes in a secret. But I know that you've done that after people, actors, and characters. But have you ever done it from, like, when your children, like, that's a character. That's a character. I'm going to make a puppet out of that.
There probably is. You know what I mean? I mean, you know, life influence influences your art. You know, I mean, they're wearing his clothes, so that's his energy being put into the art. Pretty much. So that's his.
But you're also a teacher too.
Yeah, I'm a. I teach kids with special needs at a private school, Just Right Academy in Durham, North Carolina.
Now, how does all of that help you be an effective teacher? Like, do you bring your puppets to work? Do they work with the babies?
Yeah, there? I actually built a puppet for a social skills class. Because, you know, it's kids on the spectrum, so, you know, teach them eye contact and, you know, manners, whatever. I built this puppet named Mr. Skills, and he teaches social skills.
Nice.
But, you know, me and my coworkers noticed that he had a, like, more effect on the students than we did.
Wow.
Like, you know, they would start cutting
up. He was taking over.
Like, yo, you're not doing your work. What's going on? So I would pull out the puppet, and he would ask them, you know, well, can you finish that page for me? And the kids were like, sure, Skills.
Wow.
And like doing the work. So wow. He was like a motivator. You know, when kids got stuck, I would pull him out and teach them as well. So I'm kind of like teaching with puppets.
Yeah, that's awesome. You're coming up with a whole new way to not only entertain, but to teach. And that, I'll take my hat off to you. If my hair wasn't a mess, I applaud you. Now, let's talk about the entertainment aspect of it. You're doing some shows down there. You're doing some major stuff down there. You know, what's it like? You started, you know, like painting, live painter, right?
Yeah.
What's that like?
Well, yeah, I was, I don't even know where to start, okay? I
mean, it's an interview, bro!
All right.
2006, you started as... I did.
Well, when I start taking puppets seriously, before I moved, I did a live painting for a local show in Pittsburgh on a PBS.
Oh,
with Kamal, we went.
Yes,
I can't remember the name of the show. Forgive me, it was a long time ago.
It was a long time ago.
But I was in the studio, and Fred Rogers from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood came in.
Wow. He would have loved your puppy.
No, we hung out. He like took me and my wife. My wife was pregnant at the time. Wow. He took us into his office, man. He kicked it with us for like a half hour.
Wow.
And this was when I was still like a visual artist.
Right,
so
right.
This is before smartphones, so I had my portfolio with me.
Right,
and
right.
And we talk art.
Wow.
And you know, he's like real attentive. You know, my wife's probably like, you know, she was pretty far along, third trimester. He's like, well, are you eating? What are you doing to take care of yourself?
Oh, wow.
When you have the baby, I want you to come and I want to meet the baby.
Wow. Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, he gave us Mr. Rogers neighborhood onesie. You know what I'm saying? For the baby. It was like, man, cool.
Represent the Rogers.
And that happened and he passed. And it was like, it was like a family member.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, I was going to go get some art supplies from Home Depot. And I pulled up in the parking lot, parked the car, when they opened the one in East Lydd. So I listened to NPR on the radio, you know, talk radio. So they said, right before I got off the car, I was like, you know, Fred Rogers, you know, passed away.
Oh.
I was at Home Depot like,
balling.
Like loud crying. Crying
yes.
Loud.
Like, my mom was too. Like, it was serious.
Like, yo, I couldn't hold it in.
Wow.
In public. I couldn't even, like, hold safe face in public.
I mean, that's how much you were destined. At some point, do you look and say, you know, these magnificent people have kind of placed themselves into your life.
Definitely.
To be great.
Yeah.
And not only just be a typical great, but an extraordinary great, because what you bring is not like what people are used to seeing.
Mm-hmm.
You're down here, you're out in public doing shows at colleges, you're doing shows in front. What is the response from the people? Are they interactive with the puppets? Like, how does that work?
I mean, first, if you're paying to come see a puppet show, you definitely end down with puppets. So that's a give. But, I mean, I do street performances too.
Right.
That's how I got my name. You know what I'm saying? I go and I, no matter where it's at, I would just set up shop, like guerrilla art style, downtown Raleigh. You know what I mean? During their first Fridays and just impose on people.
Wow.
And people be blown away. And I started doing parties and gigs because people like, you know, do you do parties? Or I would see a kid and like the look, the reaction on kids' faces, that's the biggest thing.
Yeah, it tells it all.
In fact, a few months ago, there was a hip-hop festival in Durham.
Mm-hmm.
And a son, about 10, and his dad, like, I had my dinosaur puppet, T-Rex. The boy was so blown away, was so so motivated and influenced, his dad went home and they built a dinosaur out of cardboard.
Wow.
And he like tagged me on Instagram.
Like, look,
yo,
word.
Like, inspire somebody.
What's it like to inspire like that? What is that feeling like?
I kind of even answer. Right. You know what I'm saying? It just makes you feel good.
Makes your heart big.
Yeah, so
like, what's the deepest thing that ever occurred to you with like doing a puppet show?
Man, something real crazy deep and spiritual happened to me. I was doing a show with a Paper Hand Puppet Intervention in North Carolina, and they had me open with a cellist puppet. I have a puppet that does Bach solos. You know what I'm saying? So I'm there, full house, and I'm doing my thing, and I'm so into it, I just close my eyes and I'm just doing it, just feeling it. Mm. And when I closed my eyes, I kind of went into this meditation, and I felt this like blue light like come from me. And then I felt it like the whole, one by one, it like spread like this blue light. All the audience just lit up blue, and I just stood there, and we all was just one.
Wow.
We were just one person.
Wow.
For that minute or 2 minutes. So that happened. So after the performance, the director of Paper Hand, his wife, beautiful sister, spiritual, she said, I have to tell you that something happened to me while you were performing.
Wow.
And I was like, what is she about to say to me?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
She said she went into a conscious meditation. She closed her eyes, and I burst into a blue flame. And then the whole audience turned into blue flames.
Same
she
thing.
Seen
what, you
what I experienced.
Wow.
That's like the most intimate thing
that
I've shared with anybody. And it freaked me out to the point I avoided her for like a few weeks. I didn't know
how
to come at her.
Yeah.
It's like she's like seeing my soul. You know what I'm saying? Mm. I kind of felt violated that she can see that deep
within me. At least
she
told you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Mm. But then I knew it was real.
Mm-hmm.
I knew it was real. I knew it was
real. She wasn't a taker. She's full of love, because a taker would have seen that and be like, oh, he's some kind of special, and would have just tried to keep seeping more of your energy. Yeah. She told you.
But for her to confirm that experience for me, what I felt,
right,
was mind blowing.
Wow.
That made it real for me.
That's dope.
So, yeah.
Wow.
You know what
I'm feeling kind of spiritual up in here. No, hallelujah.
Goosebumps.
Man. Go Live TV Hour. We're going to come back. We're going to go to a video, because that is what we do here. And when we come back, we're going to meet at least one of the puppets before he performs with another one. Go Live TV Hour, y'all, man. Thanks for watching, yo. JPB TV. Hey, if you got any questions for my man Tegetto, hit us up 412-475-8313. It's so easy. Call us, man. The phone ain't ringing. Get a brother. Call. If you're watching, call us. It ain't hard. Go Live TV Hour. Let's go.
Get so down on this bitch. Over the headphones and give me my 40, yo. Look.
I'm on my 90 shit, straight grimy shit. You don't want nothing, don't try me, kid. 40 ounces spilling liquor on my hill figure. A little bit of the burbs, a little city slicker. New Yorkers used to say that we talk country. I never really gave a fuck, I thought the shit was funny. I'm in the county, searching for a bounty. Spitting Paul Bunyan raps. Rappers looking like they're standing where they cut onions at. Bad emotional, I think back to before I had shows to do. Now you can flip through my story. I'm son of Cassie, tried to recruit me for Maury. I'm the father, tell Billie Jean don't bother. Asexual, I did the shit with no partner. Pause, but you can still get the Bozak. Nowadays half of my slang is like a throwback. This shit right here,
do I need to say it?
This shit right here,
y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here,
the proof that we made it. Do I need to say it?
This shit right here.
Y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here.
It's proof that we made it.
This shit right here. Yeah, I might wake up the one a Sean Kemp jersey, a Scottie Pippen, a John Starks, a James Worthy. Jordan poster that said license jam on it. Hoop in the backyard bed, cause I used to jam on it. A1s with the gum sole and strap hanging. 84 hatchback with the rap banging. You would've thought Red Man was riding shotgun. Hit Howard Street, where we got the latest drops from. Anything wounded, and of course big. Boot camp, Nasty Nas, native tongue shit. Gangstar, of course. said it was for the beats. Nautica shit looking like the fucking boat captain. System so loud to make you need closed caption. Gold chain and medallion, so what if it's phony? Parking lot pimping, dancing to Miss Tony. Getting trash and hitting Denny's at 2 a.m. Hit me on the beat, but tomorrow we'll do the shit again. We'll do the shit again. Hit me on the beat, but tomorrow. This shit right here.
Do I need to say it?
This shit right here.
Y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here.
It's proof that we made it.
This shit right here. This shit right here.
Do I need to say it?
This shit right here.
Y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here.
It's proof that we made it.
Just moving the beat, more in the 90s, I could be more grimy, be more slimy and dripping with ooze like Michelangelo and Donatello different. My shoes was strapped felines, before the beast was in the trap on the beehive, they was BBD high, off of that poison, never trust a big button to smell. Cousin looked up and around to see if my mama was coming, such a fine woman gone too soon. Drama was coming, wouldn't be nothing if it wasn't for us, rhyming them summers, fell asleep early just so I could catch 88.9, sticking tissue at the top of my tape, playing rewind, skating around, singing cash rules, everything around me, wrestling buddy on my hubby with me, you can never find me, truth is hooping never found me, hustling was so intriguing to me, was no hit nigga in charge like Joe on lean on me, huh, more of that sunny and closure, bro, I was slinging doja though, changing up my cologne and clothes for
this shit right here.
Do I need to say it?
This shit right here.
Y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here.
It's proof that we made it.
This shit right here.
Do I need to say it?
This shit right here.
Y'all just need to play it.
This shit right here.
It's proof that we made it.
This shit right here.
It's a new day. Around the way, wait, yo. I sleep when I'm dead, I lay my head to bed when the birds chirp. I guess my money for something priceless, how my words work. But this ain't complaining, it's called maintaining. Here this year after year, it's called remaining ink. Staining the sheets, this beat is really who I am. How you not understand, I plan this diagram to point out my insecurities, dreams and wishes to get cream and riches. Seems it's at a distance, but I keep it moving towards long-term goals. If I didn't have those, then it's nothing I suppose. So bury me, right where the red fern grows. He died in search of dot dot dot. Reads my tomb stone, cause I won't know till I get it, got it good. So I chop plots to leave a tree stump front. You probably would. Besides, dropping gems like these makes me down by law. Gravity, yo.
And the people say, it's a brand new day today. And the people say, it's a brand new day.
I'm on a mission, listen. I'm yearning to switch positions. That calls to the fire burning to increase the itching. Cause inspiration goes missing. And I need that boost to produce juicy listening to.
Word.
Hard times bring better writings, but my good days will leave your mouth agape like UFO sightings. Can have one without the other, that's a story. So keep your chin up, or you miss all this heavenly glory. When my sky's dark and gray, spark a J, find art to play my rude mood sway like don't start today. Little shit that invites a big emotion and gathers momentum downhill as it keeps rolling. It's our job to overcome the nitpick and step around life's pitfalls, y'all. We make it hit with. It's a rare gift that some don't possess. The ones that don't play this shit to hold your interest.
And the people say, it's a brand new day today. And the people say, it's a brand new day today.
My train of thought is caught and rolls on tracks and lasts long past anything that I was taught in class. This represents enlightenment. It's like vitamins. Balance your bad habits and vitamin when radio spins. Playing the CD is planting a seed. When it reaches the E&D, you're peeping an entire tree. That's growth metaphorically. Dope, yo, there's more to see. My horoscope oracle said people will see more of me. My mainframe's immortalizing pics, which is worth 1,000 words that 316s can get with. If not, I cram them way past the margin. Spark arson, my man. Said this is butter like margarine. Hit your chest like shots of hen. Cursive or print, pencil or pen. Off the dread when it begins. You wouldn't know the meaning of fresh when you're looking for a clubby type rap with auto-tune in each breath. And I'm the most vocal in sight. Matter of fact, break out the mic and let's have a stage fight.
And the people say, it's a brand new day today. And the people say, it's a brand new day today. Day to day.
Time to stand up for what's right. We must fight with all our might. Stand up for what's right. Strings attached, strings attached, strings attached, strings attached, strings attached, strings attached, strings attached. Open your eyes, realize what you believe, it's all a lie. Open your eyes, realize what you believe, it's all a lie. You all, we all, you all puppets, we all puppets, you all puppets, they all puppets. You all puppets, we all puppets, you all puppets, they all puppets. You all, we all, you all, they all. We are, you are, they are, we are, you are, puppets.
You on camera, Beast, you like it? You see yourself? Look. Where? See? Look, right there, Beast, Beast, right there. See? It's right there. Beast is live. Yeah. Hi, Beast.
I'm famous.
Go Live TV Hour. We are back. Chiquetto, who's this?
This is my man, Beast.
What's up, Beast? What's up?
Jumping, popping, cracking. Yeah.
Yeah. He's handsome. I see you on Facebook, Beast. You're kind of like a legend out here, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. Do you like it?
Yeah.
Now, here's a question. Here's a question for you. You all put together here. How long did you take to get to put together?
Are you talking to me or Chiquetto?
I think I'm going to talk to Chiquetto, but I like you. I'll be back to you, okay?
Okay.
Chiquetto, how long did it take to build him?
Probably like 3 or 4 days.
Really?
Because it took, the mouth and the face was the hardest part. And as you can see, like, our recycled materials is a pair of the khakis.
Yes.
So you see the zipper in the pockets. And his face is like the waist of the face. PVC for the mouth.
He just has his own personality, like you want to talk to him. Hi. So is that the normal time frame it takes for you to build?
No, actually,
like how long does it take you to, like, your hardest one? How long did it take you to build?
I don't have a hardest one.
Really?
This is that's a challenge, you know what I'm saying? So I'm a problem solver. Hmm. I have a vision in my head. I have to manifest in reality. Then I have to make it believable, you know, make it move. I have to breathe life into it, basically. And, I mean, I can, like, I built this spider in a day. Hmm. But the T-Rex, I built the spine and legs for it, and it sat for 2 years because I didn't know what to do with it. There's still some halfway done, so I really can't say. And then there's the reality of me, like, rebuilding the puppets after I hit a certain level of creativity. I have a whole new vision.
Yeah,
of
right.
How it should move, so I would take it apart and know, redo it.
So, like, you did that video that just went off.
Mm-hmm.
We are puppets. They was killing you. You like that beast?
Yeah.
Beast,
yeah.
My jam.
Yeah, that's your jam. That's what's up. The beast like that. That was like years ago, and that was pretty awesome.
Thank you.
You built every puppet in the video?
Yeah.
And you controlled them all?
Yeah.
Wow.
My man, J.J. Kidder, he did the filming, and he produced the jam.
So you just did the Missy Elliott new video. Pretty pro.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I can't top that right now. Right now, that's the top of my career right now. It's beautiful experience.
Now, let's talk about that a little bit because, you know, Missy was kind of not seen for a while. And as you pointed out to me in our private talks that y'all don't know nothing about, she was still working.
Definitely.
She was getting her grind on. And then, boom, she does the Super Bowl and everybody's like, yes, we miss you. Come back and do something. And then you didn't hear anything. And then she comes back with this banger.
Banger.
I mean, not only is the song a banger, but again, here's this video that's just like, where did she find these people? How did she find you?
I was in Pittsburgh. Man, my squeeze had BGP, Black Nation Gaining Empire, and my man Izzy Kizza. We used to do shows with him. And, you know, he left Pittsburgh when I did, probably within a year. And he went and did his thing. He pursued his hip-hop, and he got signed with Timberland.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying? And he ended up being cool with Missy. You know what I'm saying? So she wanted to do a puppet video. And he just, you know, behind her back, he snuck, was like, yo, she's looking for puppets. You know, build her a puppet. We'll surprise her.
So you built Pharrell?
No.
No?
I built a puppet. I'm not going to talk about it yet because she still might use it. But I built a puppet for her with my style, with what I do.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, word, you know, because I'm sending videos. I was really close to being in a Super Bowl halftime show with her, but I finished it a little bit late, and she, you know, talked to Katy Perry's people, and, you know, they do background checks or whatever, so, you know, we dropped the ball, but she's like, I still want to do a video. You know, so I'm going to keep you in mind. A few months, well, almost a year passed, and I get that phone call, like, are you still interested, you know what I'm saying? Meanwhile, you know, was the director Dave Myers. He gave me a shout out in an internet interview where her production team, Hi-Hat Productions, you know what I'm saying, it was my face, my man Kanoko, you know what I'm saying, him, Kanoko Chapel, he's bomb. Chris, Hi-Hat of Hi-Hat Productions, they are the creative team, you know, so they make everything happen. So she told them her vision. They took it and ran with it, and they had these amazing puppets built from Furry Puppet Studios.
Mm.
And they had them built, you know, sent out to L.A., but they couldn't find any puppeteers to do what they do what they want them to do.
Mm-hmm.
They said they interviewed people for months, like puppeteers, in Hollywood and L.A. They couldn't find nobody.
But it was you.
So Missy was like, yo, you know what I'm saying, I got this dude in North Carolina, get him out here. So I get that call, it's like, be on a plane tomorrow night.
And how long did you spend out there? 10 days.
10 days.
What did
hanging
you?
Out with Missy Elliott.
That's dope. Shout out to Missy Elliott. Like, I mean, I wish I could. That is, man, that's dope, yo. I'm so proud of you. I mean, you hear about veterans in the game, and you know, you hear about things in the industry, good things, bad things.
Yep.
Tell us. First of all, what's the number one thing you think you learned from this experience?
Missy Elliott's work ethic. It's still full grind. Full grind. She's just on it. She's, you know, first one, you know what I mean, there. She's making moves constantly. She's constantly checking with everything, making sure everything's right. I mean, there's hundreds of people, you know, to put this video together. You know what I'm saying? And she was like the top of all that. I mean, I couldn't imagine having that much responsibility and trusting that many people with your vision. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But, I mean, that's what she do. She pulled the best of the best to do her thing. And this is what came out. And I'm, you know, honored and blessed to be a part of that.
Man.
No doubt.
So, if you had to say, you know, this is something that I want to pattern. This is what I want to do on the next level. And this is a young kid running to you. You know, Missy Elliott, there you go. Like this. Hi, please. I haven't forgot about you. We're going to talk. But they, okay. And they run up to you and they're like, yo, you did the puppet thing. What do I got to do to kind of be like you? What would you tell them?
Tell them, be yourself. Be inspired by my work, but, you know, be your own thing. Don't be anybody but yourself. And just don't let nobody tell you that you can't do it.
Let's talk to Beast. Hi, Beast.
Hey.
Hey. What are you doing?
Chilling.
Did you like this? Did you like Grand City?
That's what this place is?
Yes, this Grand City.
It's dope.
It's dope?
It's dope.
I like you, Beast.
I like you, too.
You're handsome.
Don't make me blush.
Now, you know, the next question would be, are you a ventriloquist? Because, you know, you have puppets, and most people think you're going to... Mm,
yeah, this is the first big push in a ventriloquist. I've been trying to stay out of it. Most of my puppets are music based because I'm hip hop, so I have to, you know, like produce soundtracks. Yeah, I do soundtracks and things for my puppet shows. I do it all myself because, you know,
nice.
You can't even find anybody to do it for you, so you got to do it yourself.
No, trust me, I understand.
So I end up making scores for puppet shows. I'm actually working on a show now where I gave somebody else just full. Do what you do.
How's that feel?
I wrote my first stage production. It's called Spinocchio. You know,
Spinocchio. Dope.
It's the Pinocchio story told in the distant future, but with a robot.
Oh, wow.
So instead of a puppet maker, it's an engineer, and it's the robot who wants to be a real B-boy.
Word.
Yeah.
So are you going to film that, or are you going to do it live?
I'm going to do it live. I got a hip-hop band out of Durham. Pierce Freeland named The Beast. Mm-hmm. So I just gave them full control of the score. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You do what you do, and I work on the visual.
I'd love to come film it.
I mean, the set date is December 29th at the National Museum in Durham.
Next year. I'm there.
No, end of this year, December 29th.
Really?
Yeah. It's on.
You know, I gotta do it. I gotta figure out how to make that. Anywho, we're gonna talk about that later.
Yeah.
Hi, Beast.
Hey.
You okay? Say mic check 1, 2.
Mic check.
I tell the people that we're going to watch. Tell the people that they can watch the Missy Elliott video on YouTube.
Check it out. 17 million hits. Views. What do you call that?
Views. Okay. And tell them we'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Go live TV. Get it, Beast. Go. Oh, I can't. He's cute.
Rain falling on the city like it's God's tears. Weeping like an open soul for all the lost here. We trying to live straight, but we caught up in the crosshairs. We keep paying the price, but homies don't know what the cost is. Souls auction off the highest bidders on the block. Little youngest hold the hottest triggers on the Glock. Your shoulder got a chip, some my joint has got a rock. I see a lot of cats dying to be a nigga when they Nazi. Martin had a dream, but only hand to hand I seen this black boy slinging white off of Martin Luther King. And it's where the magic occurred. Quickest way to make compassion disappears to make the tragic occur. And I just want to show the silver lining shining behind me. But a lot of y'all are at a counterfeit, bound to get turned. These days, everybody wanna be a legend in this game. Man, I'm just trying to live up to the legend in my name. I keep taking breaks from writing and keep pledging on my chains, cause they'll snatch the title quicker than them edges if you estrange from them. Told you from the start I'm God in a human frame, trying to squeeze the life from a billion stars into a flame, to burn Babylon down so that only ashes remain. Too many dumb rappers got you like the walking dead asking for brains. I'm in the 99% out top of the class. Your favorite MC like cheap jewelry and I'm popping the class, cause every dude think he king of New York, king of the South. I'm the ruler of all mankind and my kingdom devout. I could damage a dope MC with the wrath of the math and pass around these ass whippings that I'm king to give out. I'm not here to be your pinup, I'm just trying to change the times before it's time to put my pin up. Teach my generation to keep their eyes open and chin up, and then maybe I can release some of these emotions, this pin up. The only promise I can make is that I'll be true to myself. That means I'll quit when I'm over this life, no deluding myself. Cause every time I find more success, feels like I'm losing myself. So I end up being experimental, proving myself. But no more talking till I'm blue in the face. We don't need another Krishna, I'll be the Buddha of rhyme, feng shui, the whole cipher, I'm improving your space.
I just want you to live, I just want you to breathe. I just
see my shirt, you see the shirts, what we try and do. Stop the shooting, stop killing each other. This family, we supposed to be people. Let's promote, let's lift in the community.
To the kids, want you to find bigger and better ways to get brick.
FMC roll out TV. Airing on JPB TV, Film C Rollout TV. Airing on JPBTV.com. Come, you heard it? Film C Rollout TV. All day Saturdays on the network. Check the illest, realest, independent female R&B and hip hop music videos, Film C interviews, battles, and all female ciphers. Tune in, dawn to dusk, Eastern Standard Time, Saturdays only on the network. JPBTV.com. Log on.
But you have no idea, every obstacle I went through just to make it here. Nothing was given, everything was earned. Loving this feeling because it's my turn. You think you know, but you have no idea, every obstacle I went through just to make it here. Nothing was given, everything was earned. Loving this feeling because it's my turn.
Ghetto's back. This is my T-Rex puppet. This is Dinah, the dinosaur. I'm gonna show y'all, you know, breathe life into her, show y'all what's up.
How you doing?
Brand, promoting an event, or maybe a business to show. Advertise on the go. Go Live TV Hour has spots available for 30-second video commercials, flyers, and business shoutouts during the live broadcast. Call buttons 412-475-8313 and watch Go Live TV Hour Sunday nights 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time live on jpbtv.com, uniqueblendtv.com, or from your mobile, ustream.tv/channel Go Live TV Hour. It's our power. Go Live TV Hour. It's our power. Go Live TV Hour Power. Live broadcast from Grind City. Sunday nights, 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on jpbtv.com, uniqueblendtv.com, or ustream/channel Go Live TV Hour. From your mobile, live in the mix. DJ Huda F. Ever spinning all indie hip hop and R&B videos. One feature, call 412-475-8313 and watch Sunday nights 8 to 9 p.m. Go Live TV, our power. Grass City, baby.
Another JPB production.